Hello, hello. So I ended up with a very simple system where basically I have two sets of controls. So these little yellow ones are what I call reader, and they are always aimed at my lookAt target. And another pair is these big red ones, so they will just stop following after some, let's say, extent. And this is achieved by a super simple spherical pose reader node. And what it does, if I turn on my debug, basically it reads the position of my reader control, the yellow one, and if it fits into the green zone, then the aim for the red one control is on, and if it goes out of the green zone but still in the yellow, this one is gradient from 1 to 0. And even if it gets any further, so it's even more pointing out of the cone, then it just goes to zero. So basically I have my pose reader aiming a reader control, then aiming actual eye control, which is a red one, and then I'm interpolating between animation data, like initial animation, if it's already there on eye joints. I'm just passing that from another control to one input of interpolate node, and data from a mass to another input, and interpolating between them. And then I'm just using spring interpolate, so there won't be, you know, like a sharp snap from when my aiming is turned off. And that's it. And what is good for, I still haven't implemented it yet, but I'm going to, is you can do, and you can use another spherical pose reader node for the eyelids and tweak it and manipulate it. So for example, your eye can look way up when the character looks up, but the upper eyelid, let's say, will stop aiming up at like earlier than the eye do. So the eyeball is going inside the eyelid if you're really, really trying to look up. And the same for the lower lid and like side gaze. So yeah, it's highly customizable. Thank you.